weighted item. You could use a dumbbell. I'm going to be using my trusty piece of birch wood today, and you can choose to use no weight at all. And we're going to be primarily working on the mat this morning. But let's start with a nice inhale, reach up to lengthen our body out before we get down on the mat and get going. Inhale in, exhale, reach up. We're going to go for 5 of these, then a nice overhead stretch, and then we will kick off with some nice strengthening through the abs. Hold it at the top, bring your feet together. We're going to lift up tall and ease it on over to the right, up to the center. We're going to be working on strengthening the front side of your body and the back side of your body. Let's bring your right hand down to your thigh. We'll reach up and over. Super excited today, because later in the day I'm going to head outdoors for a swim. First time in a little while, because we've had some snow recently. Let's interlace the fingers. So extra peppy day. I'm going to be getting my extra cardio in there. Bring the hands together, push your palms away, and release off. Let's bring it on down to the mat. Have your weighted option nice and handy. We're going to lie down on the back, bringing the heels down, hands gently supporting the back of your head. Everything today we're going to do in rounds of 20. So it's going to be your 20 core day. We're going to start off with an abdominal crunch, really focusing on lovely form this morning. Elbows wide, space between your chin and your chest. We're going to exhale on the way up and inhale on the way down. So modifications for you, you can lift one and sit one out. And any other exercises today, if they feel too advanced, you can come right back here. We're going to call this your home base exercise. Here we go, 9 more. Looking good. 8, 7, 6, 5 more, lovely, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, there's our 20 crunches done for our kickoff. Next one, we're going to do a modified oblique bicycle. So we're going to elbow towards the knee. You don't need to touch. You can go there, think armpit towards the opposite knee, so we're really rotating through your trunk. Again, we're going to exhale during the work phase. Exhale up, inhale down. Now, for your next 10, you can either repeat that or advance with me, where we leave the knees together, ankles together. We're going to extend one side, leave your knee above your hip. Trunk comes up, match the knees back together, and then we're going to switch to the other side. Beautiful. And rest it down. That is your 20 bicycles. So next up for us, we're going to go for our weighted object. So you could use an air weight, which is none at all. Sneaky little way of saying just use your body weight. You can have one leg up and one leg down, or advance to 2 legs. We're going to leave your head, neck, and shoulders on the mat. We're going to inhale open, and then exhale in the work phase as you close up. Slow and controlled for the first 10, and then we'll pick up the pace. Now, to make it easier, you're not going to go quite so wide. Now, if you'd like to advance, it's a shoulders up off the mat. Beautiful job. That is your first set done. Back to our ab crunch. We're going to pick up the pace here. Ready? And lift up, lower down. Two more to go. Eyes looking up. Move into your modified bicycle. See if you can get the elbow down to the mat in between each lift. Up, all the way back. All right, here comes our double leg bicycles. If you choose to advance, bring those knees together. Ankles are in line with the knees, and then I want you to mainly use the trunk. So you're going to extend away, up, over, big reach, and then we're going to match those knees. There's two. Match it up. Three. Match. Four. So remember, you've got your choices. You can leave the knees down here. We're going to go in for a crunch up and an open down, or both legs. 10 here. 2, 3. Crunch up tight. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2 more. Very good. Round 2 of 3 completed on this. So in that sequence now, I want you to try and come a little bit higher on each thing. 20 ab curls. You can imagine or even feel your rib cage moving closer to your hip bone each time you lift. That's your driving force. We're going to go 10 more. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5 more. A little bit higher. Come on, up you go. 4, you got it. 3, 2, and 1. Here we go. Modified bicycle for you. Up and over. Remember, bring that elbow back down to the floor between each rep. Okay, here goes our advanced option to make our 20 bicycles. We've got 10 of these ones. Reach, match together. Keeping my head, neck, and shoulder blades up off the mat through this whole sequence. Tapping those knees together and pausing before you go on to the next one. Last one. Okay, here we go. Grab your weighted object. So I call this little count your last one, and then we're going to advance. One leg hooks both legs, tuck it up tight, and we're going to open it, but we'll leave the hip, neck, and shoulders up this time. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, nice. Eight, nine, 10, weight goes down. Just going to release it off. So you're going to roll onto your tummy here. You're going to come up onto your elbows. Palms down, look up. We're just going to lengthen out through that. Hey, you made it through our first set of goodies. We've got three sets of things today. Our second one coming up, we're going to work on some hip lifts. Let's just release that back down again. And then this time, if you want to push it up a little bit higher, you can. Wonderful job. Down we go, one more time. Lengthening through the front side of the body. Going to hold it here for a few seconds. Excellent. And we're going to go back onto the back for a hip lift sequence. So down onto your back you go. And the first one, I call this painful walk. So you're going to be sitting down, lying down on your back, and I'll give you a demo here. Your arm's going to be above your head, and you're going to imagine rotating your trunk, painting the wall behind you. So we're really going to hit our trunk rotators here, plus rectus abdominis all the way down the front. So you're going to lie down on your back. Now you choose to use one arm, so we'll do our right arm first, and we're going to take our left hand. And if you have the range of motion, you're going to hold on to your right upper arm with your left hand. If that doesn't feel good for you, you can leave your left hand behind your head. So here we go. Take that right hand, pretend it's a paintbrush, and you're going to circle the wall behind you. And we are going around 10 times because it is 20 air day. And let's go the other way. Five, four, three, two, and one. Switch arms. Repeat. Circle. First, we're going to go in one direction. And let's reverse other direction. Try and imagine a big circle on the wall behind you. Up, across, back, and down. Two more. Beautiful. Okay, a little sneaky extra. If you can, take your hands together, cover them up, put them above your head, and I'd like you to give me 10 little lifts to the center. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Try and feel your inside of your shoulders against your ears. You got it. Beautiful work. Okay, really good hip lifts. We've got 20 of these, little fellas. Knees go together, flex the feet, and we're trying to take the knees and squeeze, press the lower part of your tummy to push those knees just a little bit up to the roof. So what we're not doing is swinging this way, it's a small little movement up using the deep lower abdominal muscles. Exhale with the lift, four more, three, two, and one. Okay, advancing. This time we're going to straighten the feet. We're going to do the same press. Try not to press through your hands too greatly. Squeeze, release. Good work. Okay, demo time. So, final little piece of this little medley. You can either repeat either of the first two options or come into a corkscrew. So this one is going to be abdominals pulled in tight as you tap your feet. Rotate up to the left. Tap. Rotate up to the right. So that is a corkscrew. We've got 10. Here we go. do another drill this time. Right arm up. Paint the wall. Big circle. Other way. Five, four, three, two, and one. Switch arms. Big circle. Up we go. Five, four, three, two, one. Bonus extra. Cover your hands up as if you are holding a $100 bill between your palm and the top of your hand. Lift it up. Lift that trunk. Come a little higher for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Fabulous. Okay, hip lifts. Little lift, squeeze lift. Really important to use the breath here. It's going to help fire your lower abdominals, transverse abdominis. Really, really good exercise to help reduce the risk of back pain. Okay, let's go for the legs extended or stay where you were. Doesn't need to be a big movement, it's more about where you're initiating the movement from. And if you want to go there, the full advance is the corkscrew. You've got a tap and a rotate left. Right. Left. Right. Good. Six more. Last one. Good. Okay, here we go, final round of this middle set of goodies. Right arm up, lift and release. Now we're gonna go for our circles, five, in one direction, three, two, one, out of the way. Switch to your left arm. Switch the other way. Five, four, three, two, and one. Check it in for those hip lifts. Just take a little moment to make sure your knees are standing above your hips. If you bring the knees forwards, you're going to lose a lot of that lower abdominal work. So it's really worked together to have a very good quality last round of this middle set. Squeeze lift. Two. Three. Four. Just check you're not pressing in hard with those hands. Three to go. Three. Two. One. Extend the legs. Maybe getting a little higher this time. I really like to try and think about trying to reach the sole of my foot to stand on the roof. So now you've painted the wall, you've stamped the roof at home, and a busy day. And getting strong reps. Corkscrew. Left. Exhale up to the right. Feet are So you're going to get a nice glute squeeze, place it down, and we're going to switch. Now the temptation is to do this too fast and let the body lift and lower as you switch, but I want you to try and be like a statue on the top bit. All right, here we go. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good, 10 more. Keep that breath moving. Getting a little work on the shoulders and chest as well. 4 more, 3, 2, 1, and stretch it back. Excellent job on that. Nice stretch through the base of the back. We're going to come into a little bit of flutter kicking. First, we're going to roll straight onto your back. We're going to flutter kick on your back, and then we're going to roll onto your tummy. 20 kicks. So you could choose to lift up your hips and slide your hands just under the base of the back for a little extra support. And if you don't like the two-leg flutter, you can do one leg at a time, 10 on each side. Otherwise, we're going to lift up both feet, head, neck, and shoulders. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 is a halfway, 10. 4-to-1 ratio, I love it. We're definitely a people of excess. Okay, you get to go back to your plank position. 20 singles, promise no down under counting on your leg lifts. Here it is. Lock it out straight. Let's squeeze through the glute to initiate that lift. We want to do it not by swinging through the trunk.10 to go. Sneaking that leg up, place it back. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You got it. Back we go. Little stretch. 20 counts. We'll try to pick on the back. One leg or two legs. 7 on up. Really engage through your abdominals. Lift it and flutter. 1, 2, 3. 14, keep it moving. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Yes, beautiful. Stretch it out. Roll onto your tummy. So, we just did our flutter kicks. We're going to do a little bit of work to finish up on the base of your back. And we're going to call these mermaid tails. We're going to do mermaid tail lifts. If that feels too much for you today, you can lift one leg at a time. Otherwise, we're going to reach the arms out and leave the hands down, like you're going to squeeze through the glutes, lift up both the legs and place them down. Squeeze, lift. Two more. That was so good. Just relax that down. Bring your hands down by your side and let those heels roll out just to release through the lower back. Now you can repeat that or you can advance with me by having an ear touch on the ground. So eyes looking down. We're going to have to start with the feet flat, squeeze, lift, and release. A little lift of the hand as well. You've got five more here. Five, four, three, two, and one. Excellent. Okay, your last one is your most advanced. And I call this the hood ornament, or if you're from down under, the bonnet ornament on the front of your car. So, you're the ornament on the front of your hood. Your hands are going to be out to the side. Your thumbs are up. Your eyes are looking down, so you're watching the road, nice and proud on the front of the car. It's a big squeeze, lift with it all, and a release down. Two, release. Three, so fabulous for the health of your back and promoting really good posture, healthy shoulders. So we really like this exercise. Five more, right here. Five, four, three, two, one, hold it up there, and you've got it. Release and relax, roll those heels out. We're going to take your hands, push you up and back, knees are open, heels are together. We're going to stretch through that back, walk your hands over to the left. Nice lengthening out through the side of that right trunk from our oblique work over the right. Very gently coming up into a standing position. How about that? Good, strong, healthy midsection after that. So impressive. We're going to inhale, a big reach up. So ab work is for everybody, and you did it today. Congratulations. Thanks for tuning in. If you missed yesterday's Crazy 8 Sweat Fest, you can check it out on YouTube. We'll see you tomorrow for ABC's Arms, Butt, and Core at 9 a.m. Thanks for tuning in.